Joe Roback, along with my co-chair Keith Wright and some other members, and we are doing the best we can to stay on target, try and get this budget done by April 21st. This is the first meeting of the Human Services Conference Committee, and we are anxious to get started. With that, I'll turn it over to my co-chair, Keith Wright. Oh, excuse me. Let me first introduce the folks from the Senate who will be participating on this. To my immediate right, your left, Senator Pat Gallivan, Senator Diane Savino, and Senator James Alesi, and perhaps we may be joined by several others as we're just wrapping up our actual legislative session as well. So we are anxious to get going, and with that, I'd like to turn it over to my colleague, Assemblyman Keith Wright.
Thank you, Senator Grobach. Good afternoon. As co-chair of the Human Services and Labor Table with Senator Roback, I'd like to welcome the public as we begin our joint conference committee process. I, too, would like to introduce members from the Assembly. To my immediate left is Assemblyman Peter Abate, Assemblywoman Amy Paulin, Assemblywoman Michelle Titus, and also Assemblyman Mike Benedetto and Assemblywoman Teresa Sayward. Thank you so much. Pursuant to the public officers law, the Assembly has appointed Naomi Golden as the recording secretary to keep the minutes and to publish the activities of the conference committee at the end of the process. The Assembly and the Senate have passed their resolutions. There are some differences, but I'm confident that through this open democratic process, we will come to an agreement and pass an on-time budget on April 1st, not April 21st.
Amen.
Yes.
Let me also say our recording secretary will be legislative analyst Tim Regazzo. And just really quickly, because some people may be participating for the first time, others may be watching it for the first time, very quickly, want to go through the guidelines that will be in place for all conference committees, especially this one. The co-chair shall determine our parliamentary procedure and how we'll move forward. The co-chair shall designate a staff person to serve as secretary for the purpose of taking minutes, which we have just done, so that is open and transparent to the public and a record. Alternatives, members may be able to participate in that, but following all the rules. No subcommittee member or alternative shall be able to be permitted to vote via proxy. So when we get to the end of this process, members will have to be here to cast their vote if we choose to move forward or we are going to send our recommendations. Subcommittees shall restrict their deliberations, my colleagues, to their requests, subject areas determined by this conference committee, which my colleague Keith Wright will clarify in a moment. And then those references will be sent back to the general big committee to move forward. Each member shall be permitted a reasonable period of time to discuss any matters germane to the subject area of this subcommittee. And no report shall be filed except upon the affirmative vote of the majority of the members of this entire body. So we look forward to moving forward and to discuss the areas that will be covered under this conference committee for clarity and for the general public. My colleague Keith Wright will read those now.
All right. The agencies that will be discussed at this Human Services Conference Committee will be the Office of Children and Family Services, the Office of Temporary and Disability Assistance, the Division of Human Rights, Office of Welfare Inspector General, Division of Veterans Affairs, Department of Civil Service, Office of Employee Relations, Public Employment Relations Board, Department of Labor, and the Workers' Compensation Board. In addition, I see Vanessa Gibson, Assemblywoman Vanessa Gibson, is also joining us.
So this is a substantial committee. Before we even get to substance, obviously, covers a wide range of areas that are very impactful to all the people of New York State, but we are going to get into those very much. let us start with the areas that the Senate and the Assembly have agreed upon in their budget resolutions. Those are ones that we can kind of move on. We have rejected the primary prevention incentive program and the restoration of programs to be eliminated under PPIP, at least to some degree. So both in the Senate and the Assembly's versions of the budget, rather than block grant, many, many important areas of programs we feel are working for young, old alike people at risk, we are at least saying minimally, even if we use the governor's number, there will be a line item remaining in the budget for some of those important things, i.e. Displaced homemakers, the COPS program, kinship care, a number of things in there, so you understand that. We have also agreed on the restoration of Title 20 cost shift proposals to make sure that stays intact, and the restoration of open-ended detention for state fiscal year 2011 and 12. Those are ones we've agreed upon by the action we've already taken in our One House budget bills.
Major issues that need to be addressed at this conference subcommittee: juvenile justice reform, local and school district cost shifts, adoption of subsidies and committee on special education, state central registry fee increase, full family sanctions, public assistance grant amount, TANF funded initiatives, group self-insured trusts, workforce development reappropriations in the Department of Labor.
I would also add that we've been joined by my Senate colleague, Senator Dan Squadron. At this point right now, we have not determined or been given a dollar amount. In the Senate's version of the budget, we did not really exceed what the executive had proposed giving to us. The Assembly had a little bit different version, so there's still going to be some dialogue in coming back to us on what the dollar amount we have to work with at this table, so we still have some major work to be done. Staff and members will be continuing to work on both that dollar amount as well as some other issues that need to be addressed but aren't included in the budget. So this committee will be very fluid, as we said at the beginning, as my colleague touched on telling you, there are some big ticket areas that we still need to address. There's much that we even have a two-way agreement on. We're going to have to get to, obviously, three-way agreement on before we can shut this committee down. And so we're going to be working very closely, hot and heavy, for the next couple of weeks, again, trying to get to that April 1st date. Before I turn it over to Assemblyman Wright, I don't know if any of my other colleagues want to chime in on anything. Senator Wright, did you have it? We're all set over here.
I'd just like to, a quick 30-second overview of what the areas of interest that we may be going over. I want to start with Assemblyman Abate to my left. Do you have anything to say?
Just basically, since the chair of the Veterans Committee is on a different conference committee, I will be representing him on some of the issues we're coming up with our Veterans Affairs during these hearings.
Assemblywoman Paula?
Is it on?
Are on.
I would just, I think that Senator Robach touched on many of the similarities between the Assembly and Senate budget as it relates to the OCFS budget, you know, Title 20, PPIP. Some of the things that we still have to work on include slight differences in the state reimbursement for the Committee on Special Education and restoration for the Safe Harbor program. Some of the we have slight differences in the fee charge. There was one fee charge that the governor put in his budget, you know, that falls within this committee. And you know, although we're on the same page in terms of direction, we you know, we have to work on that as well. So I look forward to the process and
I think we're going to come to terms in the next couple of weeks for sure.
Assemblywoman Titus.
Sure. I'd just like to just reiterate what our chairs have said, Senator Robach and Assemblyman Wright. Just looking forward to the further conversation so that we can discuss the areas that we have not come to an agreement on, such as the full sanction, public grant, and the TANF initiatives. And I just look forward to our further discussions on those initiatives.
Let me just say this. The Assembly Labor Committee supports the governor's language authorizing the Commissioner of Labor to assess employers on loans for unemployment insurance from the federal government. We have amended the governor's language on workers' compensation group trusts in order to assist employers facing increased liabilities for self-insurance, while ensuring that the board goes after the trust which did not adequately fund their responsibilities. The Assembly provided $2.7 million to restore prior year funding for employment programs that were added by the Assembly, including displaced homemakers and jobs, and for the Jobs for Youth program.
Thank you, Senator Wright. So you can see that we're well on our way, which has been agreed upon. Still some big ticket items left to go. Oh, I also want to say welcome my colleague, Senator Valmanette Montgomery, for joining us. And let me say in a generic sense, thank you, and not only my colleagues, but the public out here, I am very happy that unlike the last 2 years, when we did not utilize open and joint conference committees, I felt there was a huge lack of transparencies. We had late budgets and budgets that raised taxes, and I did not feel were particularly good for the people I represented. We're going down a much different path this year, which I think is good for government, and I think at the end of the day, we'll lead to better decisions as well. So we, again, are waiting for a dollar amount so we can try and make this work in all these target areas, again, that impact people in a huge way. We should get that in a relatively near future, and we do not have another meeting scheduled yet that will stay fluid. But that will be as open, and people will know. We encourage people to attend and see this as we move forward, and hopefully in the relatively near future, the General Conference Committee will not only in staff have a dollar amount for us, but a complete schedule of meetings as we move forward to try and shut this budget down again by April 1st. What makes sure everyone's voice is heard and that there is public dialogue and at least discussion on every important topic, funding, and policy we'll address here in this Human Services Conference Committee. So thank you all for participating and joining. You will be hearing soon of our ongoing schedule. Thanks.
Stay tuned.